Hello?
Hello?
Bill, how are you?
Yes, how are you?
I'm doing fine. Where are you?
I'm at home.
In Washington?
Yeah, I'm in Washington. I'm leaving in the morning for Arkansas.
Mm-hmm. Well, what was your score today?
Oh, hell, I just came in the office. I've been getting my notes together for Arkansas. I had to try to remember what the hell they're doing on the Arkansas River and everything else. It's a big shift of gears, you know.
Well, you tell them you bankrupted the Treasury and that ought to be enough. They ought to be satisfied. They got over 10% of all appropriations for public works.
Yeah.
And a state like Arkansas, that's a hell of a note. That's a mighty high price to pay for a couple of senators.
Oh, you're doing good work down there.
I thought maybe you would take Brother Nixon on for me today at night. He looks like a perfect setup for you. He has questioned and denounced us and assailed us. One day he wants to escalate the war, and the next day he wants to de-escalate it. And he hasn't talked to anybody in the Security Council. He hasn't talked to any of the State Department people, any of the Joint Chiefs of Staff. He has no conception of what's going on about it. He knows nothing about the Manila conference, and I guess Martin doesn't either. And Martin said yesterday in defending Nixon that when we called the Manila conference, so he said Johnson called it, the Republican Party didn't call it, Johnson called it the Manila conference. Well, of course, we didn't. Two or three of them got together and urged it upon us 3 or 4 months before we even agreed to go. But they don't know who called it. But now he says we've sold out and we've agreed to a very dangerous position. We're selling our men down the river. Because I have said that when infiltration, aggression, and violence cease, well, we get out. Sound like he wants to permanently occupy the country and keep the boys there ad infinitum. And
I don't know what the hell he's talking about. I thought you handled him yesterday in the press conference very well.
Well, but he's got a half hour tomorrow on TV, and he is he's got all the press with him now, and the boys around him are making him a big martyr because he's really he's just asking a few simple questions, and the president loses his temper and all of that kind of stuff. So I told Bill Moyer I wished he'd talk to you and maybe get a little statement up saying that you're kind of confused. You don't understand. It looks like if the North Vietnamese were willing to quit fighting and there was no infiltration and no violence and no aggression of any kind, you can't conceive of anybody in the United States wanting to continue a war. And how long does he want us to keep our men out there if we can settle at the conference table?
Yeah.
And just ridicule him a little bit.
Bill here in town?
Yeah, he's there in town. If you don't mind, I wish you'd talk to him.
I will. Where can I get him?
I'll have him call you at your home.
Okay. Just one thought I want to drop with you.
Good.
This fella nobody paying much attention to him.
Yes, I think that's
after
right.
After you commented on him, the son of a bitch immediately becomes new.
That's exactly right. I agree.
I'm a little afraid of building him up because he has no audience unless you or somebody gives it to him.
Well, I don't quite agree with that because they've got him on nationwide television, and the programs, he may get a few more listeners. He gets a lot more attention.
Well, he gets a lot after yesterday.
That's
more than today's paper up here, and he's had all year.
No question about it. He got all the headlines, and we'll get them all from now till next Tuesday because most of them are Republican papers.
Yeah.
But I think it would be a good thing if somebody of stature would say now that Mr. Nixon's up here speaking for General Theon in New Hampshire, and it's obvious that he's not in touch with the diplomatic or the military situation. I just can't believe that he wants our men to stay there always and contrary to what he says about our creating a danger situation, I have felt, and I think most Americans feel, we ought to do everything we can to get out of there.
Yeah, well, of course I do, and I agree with that completely.
Well, he got up there, though, with this fellow Loeb in New Hampshire, and... And they were giving him good attention, Bill. If you look at the Times yesterday morning, he got a whole page in it.
Oh, he got a hell of a lot more attention than he deserves. And but you're saying about him that, you know, naturally this draws attention to him.
No question about that. But he was drawing a good deal of attention. If you look at the Times and all the stories, he had the meanest speech in Memphis you ever saw. That we had to de-escalate the war. That we were killing men because we didn't give them, wouldn't turn them loose.
Oh, God.
It's just the old traitor stuff that he pulled on Truman and Rayburn. He called them traitors, you remember, back in Korea. And I think the fact he was in New Hampshire with Loeb, the fact he's speaking to this retired Air Force general who wants to bomb everything out, I think that a good man could say that he must have come intoxicated running around with this retired Air Force general, because most people thought that we ought to set a time limit. We ought to try to get out of there as soon as we could get the other side to agree.
Okay, well, I'll call Bill.
I'll have him call you.
Fine.
Thank you, Bill.
Thank you a lot.
Bye.